Good day, Minecraftians. Purple Mentat here with episode 4 of Regrowth Season 2, and I have enlisted some help. Say hi, everyone.
Hello.
There we go. We got one. Yay. I have enlisted the help of some volunteers, the Mentat minions, to do some of the more grindy stuff for me because I've spent probably 16 hours in total between the end of episode 3 and the beginning of episode 4 grinding on seeds. And I'd like to be able to work on other projects too. So when I find something that's really grindy and off camera, I'm going to be assigning it to one of these five and maybe a couple of others that'll be joining in later on to take care of that for me. For now, that's mostly going to be supplying lots of compost and chopping down trees and that sort of thing. I've chopped down the jungle tree a couple of times to get to that 2x2 so it can be a nice big tall tree. So yeah, thank you, all of you, for volunteering to help out with this and do the boring part so that I can focus on the fun stuff. It is appreciated. All right. So yeah, you guys go do your thing. What have we got? What have I accomplished since last time? Well, I have bred every single flower and mystic flower to 10, 10, 10. I think I got all the flowers. I might have only gotten all the mystic flowers. Let me double check now. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I actually only have 7 of the 16 flower types, but I got all 6, or 8. There's Allium. Now I'm not certain. Now I'm... whatever. We got all of the mystic flowers, and that's the important part. So now we have a... and they're all set up so that they give, they grow very quickly and they give 4 leaves per harvest, 4 mystic petals. So we're going to have a ton of petals for Botania. I also let the essence seeds grow. This is something that just happened while I was taking care of the mystic flowers. So now I have an arbitrary number of essence seed crops that will give me 4 essence seeds per harvest. I mean 4 essence dust per harvest. So we're in really good shape to get started moving forward. Now, let's check out a couple of things that we can do. For one, we put together the work table. I believe we collected the quest for that even. 6 quests with unclaimed rewards, all in the life of the world because I just kept breeding and breeding and breeding. Oh, hey, look, which came first? It wants me to collect eggs. We'll get to that later. Oh, wow. I forgot I got a bunch of free mystic flowers for completing the mystic flower quests. Oh, I don't have mystical pink flowers yet. Could one of you take over the flowers and breed me some mystical pink flowers, please? They are made with the purple and the white seeds. As I'm pretty sure that I skipped those and I've got light gray and brown over here. All of the flower seeds and such are over here. Thank you very much. So, I'm gonna... and Tanshi disappeared and came back. Okay. Let's get our inventory cleaned up a bit. One of the things that I've been looking forward to doing to get the inventory cleaned up is making use of this work table from forestry. Because with this down in the world, we can toss our infusion stone into it, along with our essence dust, and teach it how to make the essence dust for us so that we do not need to remember the recipe ourselves or ever input it again, like so. And now I can clear the table with this little X here, or I think with that down button will even work. Yes, it will. I can click on the weak essence and have it pop back up. And if I right click it, it will go ahead and lock in there forever. So now I can easily just turn all of my essence dust into the weak essence just by tossing it in there and shift clicking it back out. So we have stacks and stacks of weak essence already. Fantastic. Let's go ahead and make this over here our essence chest for now. I think that I'm going to be, once I have a significant amount of wood available, setting up some storage drawers in the very near future, but I'm not going to bother with that right this instant. For now, what we're going to do is we're going to start getting our runic altar working so that we can move forward in... Oh, right. Actually, before that, Natural Nuances wanted us to breed nature seeds. I went ahead and did that because I had my full-grown essence seeds. Sugarcane plus essence equals nature seeds. So I've got some 5-5-5 nature seeds here that'll start giving us this nature essence. We can use nature essence to make a lot of cool planty things. Moss, stone, bricks, lily pads, vines. Vines are super useful because you can use vines to make the ball of moss, or more importantly, where is it? Not mossy chains or lattice. There we go, the vine ball from Botania, which you can throw at the top of something and it'll grow a vine ladder down to the bottom. It's pretty awesome, actually. But yeah, the nature essence is going to be very useful for us. We can also make mycelium out of it. And we need it for our magical fertilizer, which is the really awesome thing, because now we'll be able to make a between that and our 10-10-10 skeleton seeds, we're going to be able to make an arbitrary amount of instant growth for the magical crops too. Which is going to be really, really useful once we get started with this runic altar. So first thing we need to do, we need a mana spreader here, facing into the altar from the pool, and you can double check all of that by holding your wand of the forest and mousing over it. You can see the mana spreader is full up and it's pointing into the runic altar. But before we start making big use of the altar, we're going to need a new source of power, because we have used up everything that our passive flowers could give us, and we did not even get 1/4 of a mana pull out of it. So I'm just going to use some bone meal because I have it. Oh, nope. Bone meal doesn't work. We're going to use some here. I have an overabundance of mystical blue petal. I'm just going to go ahead and grab a handful of that. We're going to make that into the blue floral powder. Any floral powder, your sugar, your gunpowder, redstone and glowstone when you get it later, toss it in a mana pool and you get the mana powder. We're going to need mana powder right away for endoflames. That's going to be our basic power generation, using mystic brown petals, mystic red petals, mystic light gray petals, and this mana powder. Now I'm just going to go ahead and make 20. Because I have the materials to do that now. That's one of the benefits of having gone through and done all of this breeding in advance. Oh, actually, I need to go get some more brown petals. That's okay. We need 40 of the brown petals, and I only have 13 handy, but what do you know? There's a full stack of them just waiting here. Nice, huh? It's one of my favorite parts about this pack. There we go. I'm also going to need seeds one time. Well, I've got some over here, don't I? Yeah, I got a couple stacks of pumpkin seeds hanging out. Perfect. So you know how this goes. This part we can't really speed up a whole lot just yet, but we will be able to in the future. It gets powder, 2 brown, 1 red, 1 light gray. Bam, 1 endoflame. The way the endoflames work is when they are down on the ground, if you were to toss a bit of fuel down there with them, which I think I've got charcoal over here. That's a good thing for you guys to keep working on, is keep the charcoal flowing. When you toss some charcoal down, boom. The endoflame lights up and starts providing power to the mana spreader. I'm going to get the rest of these made up. Minions are continuing the grind. Wow, that is a really tall jungle tree you got going on over there. Try not to slip. Okay, the firework mod is actually kind of awesome when you're watching someone else get an achievement. All right, we'll be back in a little bit, folks, once I get the rest of these endo flames together so that we can start pushing forward into getting new crops set up. Oh, and also we're going to start these nature seeds improving their way towards 10-10-10. One thing to note, when you're placing down large fields of power-generating flowers like this, your flowers, when they auto-bind, will bind to the closest mana spreader. So this endoflame right there, just going to bind to that one. But it'll show you when you mouse over the endoflame with your wand which one it's bound to. And if I hold shift and right-click, and then shift and right-click on the spreader, you can see that it is now bound to that spreader.
Power!
In fact, too much power for this one spreader to handle. Well, there's no kill like overkill, right, folks? Alright, so let's move on and start getting our quests complete. We have natural nuances finished. We've completed some nature seeds. We're going to get some lily pads and some brown mushroom spores. And that opens up the grow, damn it, quest, where we need to make some magical fertilizer. Let's go ahead and do that before we move any further. Do I have any mutandis or did I use it? I probably left it somewhere. I'll have to find it. Too many boxes and not enough organization yet. That's for the future. Don't be scared of the bone meal, folks. We have both a... Actually, you know what? I should shut off that skeleton spawner. We don't need it now. I don't have... mostly here. And make it into charcoal, too, while you're at it. Let's see. There's my mutandis. Fantastic. Alright, so we need some fertilizer. And no, not fertilizer. This fertilizer. Magical, not floral. Two nature's essence, a mutandis flower fertilizer, and a bone meal gets three magic fertilizers each, which handily completes this grow demic quest. We can pick the bone meal, floral fertilizer, or mutandis. The first two are really easy to supply, so we're going to grab the mutandis. And that gives us eight more of the magical fertilizer, which I'm going to hand over to the people that look like they're doing the flower gardening. And get back to getting on towards some metals, as we have now complete... I threw my quest book at someone, didn't I? Where'd I put my quest book? Thank you, Itanchi. Yeah, we've mostly completed the What the World Came to Be category. So now we're off to, is it What the World is Made of next? Yes, because we need to complete cuprous conduction. Or actually, don't we want that clay, where was that clayconia? There it is, clay for days. With 10 mystical light gray flowers and 12 clay. Do we have that many mystical light gray flowers? We have 7. So let me start using some of that floral fertilizer again and seeing if I can't generate more of those mystical light gray flowers. 3 more, and then we can get ourselves a clayconia and start using our mana to create the clay that we're going to need for significantly, a whole bunch of quests that are coming up. Honestly, ooh, there's 2 of them already. Hang on, one more, come on, one more. I'm running out of grass here. Come on, help me out. No? No? Sigh. That's a dark gray. Wow. No, not the petals, I need the flower. This one. Got it. Thanks, though. Cuprous, I'm being told by a viewer on Twitch. As always, I am recording this live. I need more clay. All right, then. I guess I am off to the beach to try to find some clay. So let's go ahead and make ourselves the ability to travel underwater with a snorkel, a couple of sugar canes, and a couple of glass lenses, which are made with any planks and some any glass blocks, which I've got around here somewhere. Ah, there we go. 2 glass blocks, 8 planks, and a couple of sugarcane. That'll get us our snorkel and also complete another quest. I think I have to equip this in the head slot, don't I? Yes, there we go. That is a What the World Enables? Yes. And that then asks me to find some pearl oysters while I'm down there. This is actually going to be a fairly helpful pair of quests. So I will meet you once I make it to the beach. See you over there. All right, off at the ocean we are. Now, why did I need the snorkel? Well, if you remember from when I was making sand, you run out of air real fast in this pack. And I would rather not drown trying to get to the seafloor. However, when you're wearing just a simple snorkel, your breath actually lasts quite a long time. And look, We are. Oh, that's not clay. That was limestone. Okay, that's fine. Unfortunately, whale is not going to be a lot of help down here. And if you're dealing with some... bam, there we are. If you're dealing with underwater air and light issues, you've got a couple of options. You can keep bouncing back up. You can make some jack-o'-lanterns to bring with you out of torches and your pumpkins. Or you can just stick a torch at head level every now and then to get a glance at what's around. Doesn't work that great, though, so you're better off making yourself some jack-o'-lanterns, if you remember to. I, unfortunately, did not. I'm stuck with it being rather dark. I also love the torch or bucket at head level trick to restore air. It is one of my favorite Minecraft troll physics, as you can go ahead and create a pocket of air anytime you want to. Well, we got squids. May as well kill them while we're down here. Not like we're not going to... Wow, that was a lot of stuff. Thanks, squids. Kelp forest. Bit of an issue. Oh, wow. I forgot that they even dropped anything. Uh-oh. There we are. Getting too far away from any sort of land can apparently be a problem. Oh. What have we here? That, I think, is an AE2 meteorite at the bottom of the sea. Let's get back down there and find out. Oh, and hey, there's a Buildcraft oil spout. At least I think of them as Buildcraft oil spouts. I think there's other mods that add oil now as well. But to me, they'll always be Buildcraft. I wish I could see anything other than water in Wayla, but I don't think I'm breaking through this. Alright, you know what? I'm not 100% prepared for this underwater expedition the way I thought I was. I'm gonna need to go back and get some more materials. I will be back in a moment. Alrighty, we're back at the beach with proper supplies this time. A stack of cracked sand, quarter stack of jack-o'-lanterns, and a couple of other things. One, companion scroll, as it says, it gives us the title of Nature's Attendant. We would put that in this equipment book here, right in the title section, and it gives us a pretty, pretty butterfly over our head, which I think is fantastic. I've been hanging on to that to show you guys that since we got it, and keep forgetting every time I come back in. Oh, look! Watery bees. That's awesome. Ooh, salt block. I should get that. I figured out how to make Wayla look through the water. If you open up your Wayla options, you can tell it whether liquids are visible or hidden. I had it on hidden already, but I had to open up the options for it to take effect for... I don't know. Reasons? Excellent. We're going to need that salt later when we get into mechanism. So I have been informed that I'm mostly going to be finding... if I find clay at all, it's mostly going to be around the coastline and not on the seafloor. As such, I'm doing my best to look around this area. As soon as I find a good spot, that's when I will be... Oh, come on, give me some air. Setting up a workstation underground. Hey, look, another kind of hive. There's actually a fair number of bees around here. I blame magic bees. That is a meadows hive in the middle of a wasteland. Sure, why not? Is this... Nope. Ancient sand. Okay. What is ancient sand used for? Well, one way to find out. make ourselves a bit of an airlock here so that we can survive a minute or two. There we go. And then you can clear out the water with a couple torches. Alrighty. Ancient sand. I believe you can also do this a lot easier if you just use a door. Decorative and otherwise can be smelt directly into heat-resistant glass. The only other way to make heat-resistant glass is with molten aluminum and quicklime and regular glass in a vat, so that's actually pretty great stuff. Let's see how hard it is to... Oh, effective tool, pickaxe. Have to keep that in mind. Come back for it. Still not finding any clay. We might need to look higher? In any case, you guys have seen basically what's going to be happening. I'm going to continue the search for clay, and I'll meet you back at base once we have some. And show you why this was so important. You know, actually, at this point, we've spent enough effort on it that we might have been able to do it faster just running around and punching grass. My problem is I have a really hard time telling the grass from the ground. But there's a way around that. I'll meet you back at base. Alrighty, so with 5 living wood. Uh-oh. What happened to Thera?
I've got flying squid. That's going to be one thing. There's a node here that eats stuff.
Oh, we have a hungry node? Yay! That's fantastic. With a pasture seed and 5 living wood, you can get a horn of the wild, which, if you hold down right-click, will break all of the grass that happens to be nearby. So this is probably going to be your fastest way to get to 10 clay. There's a lot of them, too. Oh, yeah. Yeah, here it is. That's definitely a hungry node pit right there. I'm a little worried about how close I can get without getting sucked in, actually. That's okay. We can get a look in there. Wow. Yeah, and it's eating a pretty good chunk right over there. It had to eat its way through enough of the ground to be able to eat into the sides of the pool so that the water would flow deep enough for the squids to spawn. And if you look, you can see the node actually right to the left of my crosshair. You'll need to go full screen to see it. It's just like a little dot that's a slightly different color that you can occasionally see particles flying into. Here, if I throw some cracked sand that way, it should fly up into it. Huh. Those items on the ground are still just out of its reach, apparently. Interesting, so it may have eaten everything it can and won't get much larger until it eats enough squids, because it's, yeah, everything's out of range except anything that might spawn near it. Huh, so it may have hit a self-limiting point, but that's not a guarantee. Alright. Me and the minions are going to go back to looking for clay. I need 3 more at this point. Oh, well, Thera got it while I was staring at the hungry node. Yay! Alright, so, with our clay, we can head back to base and get the clay conia set up. So now clay is no longer going to be an issue. See you there. Alright, here we have it. Our 12 clay and our 10 mystical light gray flowers. Submit and collect. Our reward, a single clay conia. I thought I could hold control to... That might only be while I have the actual book, the Lexica Botania, in my inventory. And I'm not sure where that got off to. Run. We'll find it. Not where I thought I left it. Oh, apparently Staff is setting up storage drawers for us. We will cover those next episode, though.
Sorry.
It's okay. I was keeping things to what I had already built, but not a problem. Huh. All right. So it's not to... I don't know where my lexicon went for that particular option, but you can always access the one that's in your library and check out what the functional flora does. In this case, the clayconia, as it says, creates clay from sand. Any nearby sand will be turned into clay, using a decent amount of mana, but nothing too insane. So we're just going to go ahead and drop you down right there, and we've got a huge, easy supply of sand. By the way, I was completely wrong about that ancient sand. That was totally limestone I found. Sadness. You know what? Let's see if we can use the red sand. Now everybody's checking every chest. Yep, poof. Place down sand, one block of sand, get one ball of clay. And it'll go almost as fast as you can hold right click. And in fact, if you do so while moving back and forth a bit, you can get even more out of it even faster. Whoa, screaming from outside. Poof. There we go. That's enough clay to get started. So, to get our first bits of seeds, we need to go for cuprous conduction. 4 weak essence, 16 floral orange powder, and 16 clay. And let's see, where are our orange petals? There's 16. We've got the clay already, and here's the weak essence that we've been making. So now we have a nice large supply of everything that's going to go into these, which is good, because from what I remember, they're repeatable, but it is a little on the slow side. And to get our copper seeds, we're going to need 4 of these essence of copper before we can move on with that. But that's all right. We've got plenty of other seeds that we'll be unlocking as we go. So next is Ferric Fidelity using weak essence, gray powder, and 16 red sand. Well, that might be an issue. I just used up all of my red sand. that requires alchemy. Well, I am a little red in the face now. That's annoying. Oh well. We can also do the carbon connection using charcoal, floral black powder, and weak essence. So I'm going to need to collect a lot more red sand because I just used all of it to make myself clay. Ah! Bad Mentat. Here we go. Let's at least get the carbon one done, huh? Boom. And that opens up our quest for the coal seeds. And the coal seeds are going to work much the same way. We need to get our hands on 3 essence of coal before we can make them. So that is going to take a number of in-game days, but luckily in 14 in-game hours, which is less than 10 minutes, we'll be there. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time getting the red sand that I'm going to need to actually complete the iron quest, and we're going to spend some in-game days wading through and getting ourselves to the essence of copper. One other thing that you can do, though, is you can go ahead and go straight for the regular infusion stone. Actually, no, you cannot. To make the regular infusion stone, you're going to need essence of iron, essence of dye, essence of coal, essence of copper, and essence of tin. You're not going to want to spend your first essences making an infusion stone. You're going to be better off using them to get the seeds made first. We can, however, get our dye seeds made. That's an easy one. Dye seeds are created with black dye, basically, you need white, yellow, gray, blue, brown, green, red, and black dyes in any form. They can be floral powder, they can be extra biomes, they can be ink or bone meal, just pretty much any form is acceptable for this quest. So I'm going to go ahead and get that recipe set up. We already have the two essence and one essence seed that it's going to take. Once I go get the rest of the dyes, I'll be right back. Alrighty, as you've seen, Runic Altar, anytime you need to add ingredients to it, all you need to do is mouse over and right-click with the ingredient in hand, and... Whoa. So that starts automatically these days. Wasn't expecting that. Interesting. So, wow, sixes is Sorenchenst. This works a little bit differently than I remember. Once you have the full recipe complete in there, it will start processing immediately and the mana spreader will fill it full of the mana that it needs. Once you get that check mark, you'll need to put a piece of living rock on top and whack it with your wand of the forest to complete it, which will get us, in this case, our first dye seeds. And one dye seed we can either get two essence of dye or three weak essence. I'll take the weak essence, because the essence of dye, we're going to get plenty of that when we start farming these dye seeds. Now, if you hit U over the dye seeds, it'll tell you what kind of soil that you need. In this case, we're going to need tilled garden soil, and they are, of course, going to have to be on crops. And as you can see later on, they are used to produce lapis seeds, which are quartz. For now, though, I think that we're just going to set them up on a bit of a snake and let them go. Let Thera here keep them fertilized. Oh, these weren't tilled. My bad. There. Oh, if you hold shift and right click, you'll put down two at a time. All right, I think that puts us in a pretty good spot, and judging by the times, looking at the video clips so far, we've got a nice full episode 4 here. So, thank you very much for joining us. I hope you have enjoyed today's episode. If so, leave me a thumbs up, tell me what you liked. If not, leave me a thumbs down, tell me what you didn't. Either way, if you'd like to see more of this series, please click subscribe. Between episodes, we'll get what we need to make our iron, copper, and coal seeds. We'll see you next time.